In this lesson, we are going to see what is a zoonosis and how can infectious agents be transmitted from animals to humans and cause diseases. You will also learn how you can protect yourself when you're abroad and how you can prevent the spread of diseases to other people and animals when you will be going back. Zoonosis is defined as any disease or infection that is naturally transmissible from vertebrate animals to humans and vice versa. It is estimated that 6 out of 10 known infectious diseases of humans are in fact spread from animals. Animals share different pathogens with humans. Over 200 common infectious agents have been described, including bacteria, parasites, fungi, and viruses. People interact with animals during their everyday life, at home or outside, all over the world. They may be a complexity of interaction among humans, animals, and be different environments they live in. This is particularly true in several developing countries, where people used to live in close contact with either domestic animals, pests, and wildlife. It is important to know that sometimes animals may appear healthy while they are not, being able to transmit zoonotic agents that can make people sick or even cause their death. During your stay abroad, you may experience direct or indirect contact with animals. Direct contact may happen when touching animals or through bites and scratches. Zoonotic agents can be also transmitted by indirect contact with environments where animals live, or surfaces, objects, water, soil, food contaminated with their saliva, blood, urine, feces, and nasal secretions. Now, let's see how you can become infected through bites and scratches of different animals. Animal saliva can be highly contaminated by viruses and bacteria. For this reason, if you are licked on a pre-existing scratch, this may be enough to cause you an infection. Animals are cute, but even if they seem friendly, they may be dangerous as they can bite or scratch to protect their territory or because they are frightened. All mammals are able to transmit rabies, but dogs are more commonly involved in the transmission of the disease, thus responsible of most rabies death. Rabies is almost always fatal if exposed patients are not promptly treated with rabies shot. Post-exposure prophylaxis, PEP, but in some countries it may be not available. Rabies vaccination is always recommended for people staying for a long time in high-risk areas, people involved in outdoor activities and exploring caves and mines, people working with animals, and children who tend to play with animals. Even vaccinated people must get PEP as soon as possible if they have been exposed to animals that might have rabies. In fact, vaccination only buys more time to get treatment after exposure. Besides rabies, pre-exposure immunization in case of bite, it is important to check tetanus vaccination documentation confirming an immunization in the previous 5-10 years. Monkeys and apes' bites and scratches may also transmit rabies, but these animals are also able to transmit other serious diseases such as Ebola, Marburg, and tuberculosis. For this reason, it is important to avoid feeding or touching monkeys anywhere in the world and be careful as they may become aggressive if they smell food. Suspected or documented bat bite anywhere in the world has to be considered at risk of rabies. Bat saliva can also be infectious if it gets into eyes, nose, mouth, or wound. Sometimes bites are not clearly seen as bat teeth may be tiny. For this reason, it is necessary to seek medical care even in the absence of an apparent wound if bats are found in a room where you have slept. Bats may also transmit other serious diseases, so never handle bats. Rodents such as rats and mice can spread many diseases through bites and scratches, but also through an indirect contact with their urine, feces, or their fleas. Diseases include rabies, but also plague and hemorrhagic fever. Avoid rodent-infested places and do not touch anything that may be contaminated with their urine and feces, including water. Never handle wild rodents. Now let's see what you should do if you are bitten or scratched. First of all, promptly clean the wounds with running water and soap. Second, contact a healthcare provider for rabies and tetanus PEP. Antibiotic course may be also appropriate to prevent local or systemic bacterial complication. Direct contact with asymptomatic birds may transmit highly pathogenic avian influenza to humans. If the disease has been reported in the area, avoid direct contact with live poultry markets, backyard farms, and contacts with wild birds. Avoid uncooked or undercooked poultry meat and dishes containing uncooked egg and poultry blood. Bird feces may also transmit different pathogens through indirect contact with feces. Wash your hands with running water and soap if come into contact with bird feces. In the Mediterranean basin, South and Central America, Eastern Europe, Asia, Africa, and the Middle East, brucellosis is enzootic in cattle, sheep, and goat populations. To prevent human transmission, avoid the consumption of unpasteurized dairy product or undercooked meat and direct contact with infected animals that have recently given birth or had abortion. Hunting can be a risk for exposure to the bacteria, as wildlife can be a reservoir and brucella can enter the body via skin wounds or inhalation. Avoid any direct contact with infected animal carcasses or eating uncooked or undercooked meat from animals that were sick when slaughtered, as you may become infected with anthrax. Anthrax may also be indirectly transmitted through handling animals' parts, such as hides, or products made from those animal parts, such as animal hide drums, meaning that souvenirs made from animal parts may be dangerous. Anthrax is most common in agricultural regions. Vaccination against anthrax is not available for civilian travelers. Walking barefoot may always pose health risks, such as cutaneous larva migrans. Parasites are shed in the feces of infected animals and can end up in the environment, contaminating the ground where the animal defecated. Hookworms penetrate unprotected skin, resulting in disease when the larvae migrate through the skin and cause inflammation. Now, let's recap all the preventive measures to protect yourself from zoonotic diseases when abroad. First, do not get in contact with stray dogs and cats. Second, never handle or feed unfamiliar animals, even pets, when you're abroad. Third, avoid being bitten or scratched. Fourth, always wash your hands after being around with animals, even if you didn't directly touch them. Fifth, keeping hands clean is always recommended, as many diseases are transmitted by not washing hands properly with soap and clean running water. If running water is unavailable, use at least soap and available water. If water and soap are not available, use alcohol-based sanitizer containing at least 60% alcohol. Now let's see how to protect yourself and others after dealing with animals from abroad. Avoid adopting and importing stray animals from foreign countries, as they may pose human and animal health risks. If the intent of travel is to rescue animals, participants should always discuss rabies PEP with healthcare providers. All rescued animals should be examined by a veterinarian both before departure and after arrival. Animal skin souvenirs, such as cow leather products and goat skin drums, have been associated with cases of anthrax in humans. Avoid importing these items from anthrax-infected areas. Avoid importing bushmeat, since it has been linked to deadly diseases like HIV, AIDS, and Ebola in humans. But it may also pose risk to local fauna. If you get sick after travel, inform your doctor that you have been in contact with animals.